Hello and welcome to this Lumineth Realm Lords Battle Ready video. The Lumineth Realm Lords are elven warriors from the Realm of Light, also known as Heesh. They are incredible intellects that have now attuned their business to war. In this video, we'll be taking you through a step-by-step guide on how to paint these models. We'll be painting a Venari Aurelan Warden, we'll be painting a Venari Dawn Rider, and the Light of Alfarion. We'll also be painting them in the colours of the Great Nation of Ymetrica, which are the ones that you find on the box cover. Now, the first model we're going to pick is the Venari Aurelan Warden, which is the Spearman. Now, we paint them in both classic and contrast methods and up to battle ready. But the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. Now, as you can see here, I've undercoated the model with Corax White, which is perfect. I've also left the shield off just because it's a lot easier to get into those little nitty-gritty bits. So without further ado, let's start painting our first colour. So I'll be using Iron Hand Steel, so I'm just going to pop that open like so. Now, this is going to be for the armour trim and also for his blade of the spear as well. So I'm just going to add a little bit of water to this so it's not too thick and goopy. Get a nice point to the brush. And we're ready to start picking that out. So all I'm gonna do, like I said, is the trim on the armor is just this little raised, nice little filigree detail you've got here. So just take your time, pick that out, and don't forget to paint the blade of your spear as well. There we are with all those silver details now picked out on the model. You'll also notice I picked out the scale mail, and don't forget to do the details on the shield as well. So what I'm going to do now is move on to applying a contrast over the whole model. For this, I'll be using Skeleton Horde. So what I'm going to do is use my medium shade brush. I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette. This is so I just don't overload the brush too much. Know that I'll get a nice point and I'm ready to start coating. Now, the idea of this is really to concentrate on the robes and the armour, but obviously you'll get it on other places as well. I'm going to avoid trying to get on the plume if I can. It just saves tidying up later on. Take your time, and if you do find it pulling at the bottom, just use your brush to soak up any excess. And with the Skeleton Horde now dry, you'll notice that the trim of the armour has just been toned into a more of a yellowy tone that looks like light brass that's more in keeping with the box art. And I've also quickly tidied up the scale mail, ready for later on. So what I'm going to do now is move on to applying some more base coats. Now I'm going to start with Corax White, which is going to be for the armour panels. After that, we'll move to Mournfang Brown, which is going to be the shaft of the spear and also his scabbard as well. After that, we'll use Lothian Blue for the plume and any blue details. Then we'll finish off with the base coats by using Retributor Armour for any gold details. But first of all, let's start applying that Corax White. So all I'm going to do is get a little dollop, add a little bit of water, and again get a nice point here. And what you're aiming to do is pick out those flat panels, or I say flat panels, the armour panels, with inside the trim, like so. And also, we'll be picking the trim on the skirt as well. So just take your time and just layer it up. And you might want to do a couple of coats of this as well. There we are with the armour and the trim picked out in Corax White. We're going to move on to Mournfang Brown. This is for the shaft of the spear and also his scabbard as well. You might want to do a couple of coats just so none of that white shows through. With the shaft and scabbard now done, we're going to move on to applying Lothian Blue to the blue detail. So you've got the little plume on his helmet to do. You've also got the skirt at the front and there's a couple of little ribbons scattered across the model. If you're not sure, just check the box art for details. With those blue areas now picked out, we're going to move on to the gold, and for this we're using Retributor Armour. So there's a few little gold details around, so if you're not sure, just check your box art. With the gold done and all the base coats finished, we're going to move on to applying some shades and contrast. Now, first of all, we'll start off with Wildwood, which will be for the leather and the boots. After that, we'll move on to Gunnerman Flesh for the skin, then we'll use Reichland Flesh Shade for any gold details, and then Agratzer Shade for the scabbard and the shaft. But first of all, let's start with the Wildwood. So again, I'm going to be using a small layer brush for this, just more for control. I'm just going to apply some to the palette, get a nice point just so I don't overload the brush, and then we're ready to start doing it. So like I said, there's a couple of areas to pick. So you've got like the boots at the bottom, you've also got the gloves here, and at the back, there's just some leather straps just holding that breastplate in place. Take your time, and in some places, especially the boots, you might want to do a second coat. With those leather details picked out, we're now going to pick out the skin using Gulliman Flesh. So you just mainly got the face here to do, but there's a little bit around the neck as well. With the skin now done, we're going to move on to picking out the gold details using Reichland Flesh Shade. Just take your time and make sure it doesn't pull in those recesses. Now that the Reichland Flesh Shade's dry, we're going to move on to applying Agratzer Shade to the shaft of the weapon and the scabbard of the sword. And there we are with the scabbard and the spear shaft now coated in Agratzer shade. We're going to move on to applying the rest of the shades and contrast paints. Now we're going to start with a Keeling Green, which is going to be for the scale mail. We'll then move on to Norn Oil for the spear tip. After that, I'll be using Ultramarines Blue for the blue areas, such as like the plume and obviously the little cloth bits and ribbons that hang off the actual scabbards and stuff. And then we'll finish off by using Volupus Pink, and that's just going to be for the sword handle on his back. So first of all, let's start with that Keeling Green. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette, like so, not too much. And I'm just going to add a little touch of water. I don't need to really thin it down that much. Now I'm just going to get my brush to a nice point, and then I'm going to start applying that to the actual scale mail. So it's just these little bits here. So all I'm going to do is just start running that across like so. After applying the Keeling green, it's worth just highlighting some of those scale mail bits with a little bit of iron hand steel just to bring out some of that nice bling silver effect that you expect from scale mail. So what I'm going to do now is apply some Norn oil to the spear tip. So all I'm going to do is just run that down the blade like so. Obviously you'll need to do both sides, so once one side's done, just move to the other. With the spear tip done, what we're going to do now is move on to applying Ultramarine's blue to the blue area. So we're going to do it all over the skirt and also the ribbons. But actually on the plume, what we're going to do is just do a little colour, well, three little colour areas. So like little flashes of colour. So once I've done this little skirt bit here, I'll show you what I mean. So once I've done that, apply that over. Again, do the same thing like you would on the ribbons. The actual plume itself, all I'm going to do is where the little gold bits are, is just do three little flashes of colour. So one there, just like you see on the box art. If you do get some on that gold, just tidy back up with a little bit of Retributor on there. There we are, the blue details picked out. Also, it's worth remembering to do the little symbol on the shield as well. So what we're going to do now is we're going to move on to applying the Lupus Pink, and this is just to the handle or the grip of the sword. I'm just going to spin that around like so. Just do the back like there. Again, you might want to do a second coat if it's not bright enough. There we are, the sword handle now picked out. We're going to move on to applying some texture to the base. Now for this, we'll be using Aguiline Earth. So what I'm going to be doing is grabbing my trusty texture tool. So I'm just going to scoop some out like so, just using the large side first. And then all I'm going to do is then start dolloping that actually onto the base. So I'm just going to do a couple of dollops like so. And then as I get close to those feet, I'm just going to move to the smaller side, just for a bit more accuracy, and move that in. Now the more you apply this, the bigger the cracks will get. So obviously just be neat first, and then apply some more after. You probably want to leave it to dry for around about an hour. Once that's done, paint the rim of the base in the colour that matches your force. And also once that's done, I'd recommend gluing the shield on as well. And there we are with our Venari Aural and Warden now done. We're going to move on to our next model, which is the Venari Dawn Rider. And again, we'll need to undercoat this model. As you can see here, I've used Korax White Undercoat. So it's very similar to the previous model, but obviously it's a different shape model with different bits on it. So we're going to start off by picking out the Iron Hand Steel, which is all on the trim of the armour. So again, just dollop some of that onto the palette, a little touch of water, not too much, and get our brush to a nice point, and we're ready to start picking out those details. So I've kept the shield off for this one as well, just because it means it's a lot easier to get into all those bits and bobs. So all I'm going to do is just start on the shoulder pad, work my way around. If you're not sure, look at the previous one, or actually just check your box art for details. There we are, with all that silver trim now picked out, what we're going to do now is we're going to move on to applying a contrast. We're going to place all over the model before we apply any more base coats. So what I'm going to do is grab my medium shade brush. So I'm going to apply some to the palette like so. This is just so I don't overload the brush too much. Get myself a nice point to the brush like so. And then we're just going to coat this over pretty much everything, so including the horse. This will get us ready for later on when we start applying colours to that horse. After this is dry as well, it is just worth picking out things like the face with a little bit of Korax White. This will just make it easier when you start applying the flesh colours later on. There we are with the skeleton horde now thoroughly dry. We're going to move on to applying the rest of the base coats. Now we're going to start by using Korax White. Now this is obviously for the armour panels, but if there's any areas you need to tone up like the face and the plume, now's the time to do that as well. After that, we'll be using Mournfang Brown for the scabbard and the spear shaft. Then we'll be using Lothlin Blue for any blue details on the model. Then we'll finish off by using Retributor Armour for any gold details. But first of all, let's start with that Korax White. So I'm going to apply a little bit of water, a little bit more than I normally would when doing base coating, just because it runs into those cracks a lot easier where you've got all that nice filigree of the armour. So all I'm going to do is just get a brush to a nice point. Two-ish brushes of water, just to give you a nice ratio. So you've got all these armor panels all scattered around. So I'm just going to start on the large one here. Very similar to the Venari Aural and Warden. So just look on the box if you're not sure where to apply these little bits of white. When you've done the armor, you've also got like a trim on the cloth as well to do. With those white details now picked out and any tidying up done, we're now going to start painting the scabbard and the spear shaft using Mournfang Brown. Here you might want to do a couple of thin coats just because some of that bone will show through. With the scabbard and spear shaft now done, we're going to move on to picking out the blue details. Now there's quite a few on this model, but I'm going to start with the plume. So all I'm going to do is just start covering that all over with Lothlin Blue. In some places you might need to do a second coat, but you've got quite a few areas to coat. So there's some little tassels down here, you've got the little pendant on the back. If you're not sure, just check the box art. Now that we've picked out all those blue areas, we're going to move on to the gold. So there's a few details. So you've got a lot of bits on the scabbard for his sword, you've got some bits on his spear as well. There's also these sigils on the actual armor. However, on the actual shield, you need to be leaving those because they'll be painted blue, but the rest paint gold. And again, if you're not sure, just check the box for details. And there we are with the gold details picked out. All our base coats are finished, and we're now going to move on to applying some contrast and some shades. Now, we're going to start first of all with Wildwood, which will be for the dark leather areas and also the hooves of the horse. We'll then move on to Gunman Flesh for his face. Then we'll move on after that with Reichland Flesh Shade for any gold details and Agratz Earth Shade for the shaft of the weapon and the scabbard. So, first of all, let's start applying that Wildwood. So, what I'm going to do is apply a little bit to the palette, not too much. This is just so I can get my brush to a nice point. So, you've got a few leather straps on the model and also the back of his boots as well. So what I'm going to do is start picking on the back of the boots here. And like I said, there's some straps here and just some around the back there, which will be a bit tricky to get to, but take your time. If you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up with some base paints and reapply any shades if you need to. With all the brown details picked out, what we're going to do now is move on to picking out the flesh using a little bit of Gulliman flesh. So we're just going to run that into the helm like so. Again, for more definition, it's always worth adding a second coat. Just wait for the first one to dry first before you do that. There we are with the skin now done. We're going to use Reichland Flesh Shade to pick out any gold details. So just take your time, start working around them. Now that we've shaded the gold, we're going to start shading the brown areas such as the scabbard and the spear shaft. Again, just take your time, don't overload your brush. With the Agratz Earth Shade now dry, we're going to move on to applying it the rest of the contrast and shades. Now we're going to start with a Keeling Green, which is going to be for the scale mail. After that, we'll use Nornoi, which will just be for the blade of the spear. Then we're going to use Griffhound Orange, which we're going to apply all over the horse, including the mane. And then after that, we'll be using Ultramarines Blue for just some blue flashes and some cloak bits as well. Then we'll finish off with Volupus Pink, which is going to be for the sword handle. First of all, let's start with that Keeling Green. So what I'm going to do is just dip in there, pop a little bit on like so. I'm just going to add a little touch of water, not too much. And then we're ready to start applying that into that scale mail. So just take your time when you're doing this. So you've got a few little details scattered around the model, so just be mindful of that. And just start applying that in like so. Now that we've applied a Keeling Green, after it's just worth adding a little bit of Iron Hand Steel to some of those scale bits, just add a bit more blingness to it. So what I'm going to do now is move on to applying Norn Oil to the spear tip. Again, try not to overload your brush. If you do see it pooling, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Now that we've done the spear tip, we're going to move on to the horse flesh. And for this, we're using Griffhound Orange. Now, for this one, I'm using it straight from the pot. But if you wanted a lighter tone, you can just thin it down with a little bit of contrast medium. And as you can see here, I'm applying it straight over the base coat of Skeleton Horde. This will add a bit more depth into those recesses. Now that we've done the horse skin, we're going to move on to applying Ultramarines Blue. Now, this is mainly for the things like the tassels. You've got the little tassel here and also the pennant and the robe down here. Now the actual plume itself, we're going to leave light blue apart from the odd little flash here. Now if you check the box art, the little flashes of colour tend to be where these gold beads are. So just neatly just work your way up through those strands like so, and applying the Ultramarines Blue. And also don't forget to do the decal on the shield as well. For all those blue details finished, we're now going to just finish the model off by applying Volupus Pink to his sword hilt. Just be super careful when you get close to this arm of it here. If you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up with Corax White. There we are, with all those contrasts now applied, we're going to move on to adding some texture to the base. Now, for this, we'll be using Agrion Earth, so I'm just going to grab my trusty texture tool, start with a large scoop side first, so I'm just going to scoop some out the top like so, just get a bit more like that. I'm just going to dollop that onto the base. So all I want to do is just put some like there, just move that round. And then as we get close to things like the hooves, just use the smaller side like I'm doing here. Now, once you've applied this on, you want to give it around about an hour to dry, and then paint the rim of the base in the colour that matches your force. For this, we'll be using Steel Legion Drab. And also, don't forget to glue that shield onto the model as well. There we are, with the Venari Dawn Rider now done, we're going to move on to our final model, which is the Light of Eltharion. Now, we'll need to undercoat this model, and as you can see here, we've used Corax White, which is perfect for these colours. So the first colour we're going to be using is Iron Hand Steel. So what I'm going to be doing is just applying a little bit to the palette, a little touch of water as well, just so it's not too thick and goopy. Then we're ready to start applying. I'll just get it to a nice point. There's a few areas to pick out, so we'll just pick the model and point it out. So you've got a couple of bits here, so just a little bit on the crest, his belt. He's got like a little bit of trim on his headdress and then his swords as well. So we'll start with the swords and work our way around. If you're not sure, just check the box art for details. There we are with the silver details now picked out. We're going to move on to applying some more colours. Now I'm going to start by using Skeleton Horde, which is for mainly most of the model, so over the armour and stuff. We'll be thinning this down with Contrast Medium. After that, we'll use Corax White for any tidying up and also to pick out some of the armour panels. Then after that, we'll pick out the robes using Black Templar. But first of all, let's start by applying that Skeleton Horde. So first of all, I'm going to apply two dollops, Contrast Medium, and then one dollop of Skeleton Horde. Just mix that together like so. So that should be nice and thin enough. Load my brush it, but not too much because I don't want it to like swamp the model. So what I'm going to do then is now start applying that over. So as we start applying it, I'm going to avoid these head crest bits here because it just saves you tidying up later on. But everything else you can just coat over. There we are with the Skeleton Horde dry. What we're going to do now is use Corax White just to tidy up some areas and pick out some details. So you've got like the little gem on here. There's a scabbard that we'll need picking out and also the sword hilt as well. If you need to tidy up the crest, do that now as well. There we are with the white details now picked out and any tidying up done. We're going to use Black Templar to pick out the cloth or robes. So just take your time. And if you do make a mistake, just reapply Skeleton Horde and just tidy back up. There we are with the Black Templar now applied and dry. We're going to move on to applying the final colours. Now for this, we'll be starting off with Norn Oil, which will be for the sword blades. We'll then move on to Ultramarines Blue for the little tassels and ribbons. After that, we'll use Xandra Dust, which is going to be for the stonework of the base. And then we'll finish off by using Griff Charger Grey, which will be for the hair crest, the sword handles, and also to apply over that stonework on the base as well. But first of all, let's start applying that Norn Oil. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette, like I say, not too much. Get my brush to a nice point. I'm using a medium layer here as well, just because it's not too large. And I can still get a nice point to it. Like I said, we're just going to be doing the sword blades for this. So I'm just going to start with this one, avoiding these bits here, because obviously you've done those as like a brass as opposed to a silver. So just work your way along, let it sink into those details, and then do both sides. Now that we've shaded the swords, we're going to move on to those tassels and ribbons. And for this, we'll be using Ultramarines Blue. So just work your way along, picking each one out. There we are with the ribbons and tassels picked out. We're now going to start working on the base. And for this, we're using Xandra Dust and we're just picking out the stone pillars. As you can see, I'm using a medium base brush for this as well. There we are with the stone now picked out with Xandra Dust. We're going to be using Griff Charger Grey. We're going to apply that all over the stonework. We're also going to apply it over his crest, the handles of his blade as well. With the Griff Charger Grey now dry, we're going to move on to adding some texture to the base. Now for this we'll be using Aglan Earth. I'll be grabbing my trusty texture tool and starting with the large scoop side first. So I'm just going to grab some in onto the actual scrapey bit like so. And just dollop that onto the actual base. So I'm just going to move that around like that. I'm going to get a second dollop as well. Place that on. Now this is the easiest part on the flat bit here, but actually when we get to the detail around here, I'm just going to move to the smaller side and then just start being a bit more accurate and then moving that onto the actual texture. I'm actually going to coat some of this sand as well just to tie it all in. The rest of the base. Another thing to bear in mind as well is trying to fill these gaps a bit. So where the molded base is, just push it in a bit like so. Once you've applied all this, you want to leave it for around about an hour to dry. And once it's dry, paint the rim of the base in a colour that matches your force. And for this one, we're using Steel Legion Drab. There we are with the texture now dry and the rim of the base painted. The Light of Eltharion and all our Lumineth Realm Lords are battle ready. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting these models. Firstly, when using base paints, try and be as neat as you can. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. And if you do make any mistakes, you can always tidy back up at a later stage. And also when using contrast paints and shades, try not to overload your brush as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own battle-ready Lumineth Realm Lords. And we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.